WYFF News 4, live local breaking news at 6.
They're going to have to come down and explain to you why they don't have an answer for how we're putting Americans to work right now.
President Obama chooses the Carolinas to build support for his jobs plan. Good evening. Welcome. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. The president spoke at the Asheville Airport this morning.
It's his third visit to North Carolina in 5 months. And today, with national media watching, he took a jab at some of the Senate Republicans about jobs. News 4's Myra Ruiz covered the president's visit today and has more for us tonight from Buncombe County. Myra.
The president was greeted by a crowd of people shouting, four more years, but he said he's focused more on the next 13 months. He stood up in front of that flag and said that independent economists say his bill could create up to 2 million jobs in this country.
We can't do nothing. Too many folks are hurting out there to do nothing.
While critics argue nothing is exactly what the president's past efforts to create jobs have done, Obama says he's still pushing Congress to pass his American Jobs Act.
We're going to give them another chance to do their jobs by looking after your jobs.
The president says this week he'll ask lawmakers to approve part of the plan,
which is whether we should put hundreds of thousands of teachers back in the classroom and cops back on the street and firefighters back to work.
Critics say these are jobs not typically funded by the federal government and argue that the proposed money only covers these jobs for 1 year.
I want to work with Republicans on ways to create jobs right now.
Some supporters say they're a bit underwhelmed by the administration's efforts so far.
Well, we all thought he was Superman, didn't we, when he was running before. And I think he's done a number of really good things, but he needs to get that message across.
I think if the economy gets better, then a lot of the other problems will solve themselves.
Hopefully the people come back out and support him despite what he's going through. Thus far.
A presidential push to get folks to urge Congress to pass his plan or else.
They're going to have to come down to North Carolina and tell kids why they can't have their teachers back. They're going to have to come down to North Carolina and look those construction workers in the eye and tell them why they can't get to work doing the work that America needs done.
The president choosing to start his Jobs Act bus tour here in Asheville after saying he could be an ambassador for tourism in the city, but also alluding to all the jobs that could be created in this area. Myra Ruiz, WYFF News 4, Asheville.
All right, Myra, thank you. Also today we talked to U.S. Senator Lindsey Graham about the president's bus tour. The senator is back in the upstate, and our cameras caught up with him today here at the Poinsett Club on East Washington Street in Greenville. He was the keynote speaker at the Upstate Republican Women Luncheon, and we asked him today what he thinks about the president's jobs bill.
So I believe that the president's jobs bill failed in the Senate because it's unsound policy. It creates class warfare. It creates new taxes when we should have lower taxes. And you can break it apart. There may be things I could support, but I'm not going to support class warfare as a way to run the economy in the 21st century.
The president's jobs tour will take him through North Carolina and into Virginia.
A Walhalla High School student died after her car crashed near Seneca. According to the coroner, 16-year-old Kylie Evans wrecked around midnight Sunday. It happened near the intersection of Davis Mill Road and Wells Highway, but the wreck wasn't found until 6:15 this morning. The coroner says Evans' vehicle crossed over Wells Highway, went over the guardrail, and down a hill. It flipped several times. Evans was thrown from the car. An autopsy shows she died of traumatic asphyxiation. There is still no suspect in the case of a family gunned down in Pickens County. News 4 has learned the woman who found her family dead on Friday shot and killed an intruder at the family home in self-defense 5 years ago. It's another twist in the murder mystery. News 4's Angela Rodriguez is here with the latest. Angela?
Carol, four members of the Hendricks family were shot to death on Friday. That we know. Investigators say the past is certainly fueling suspicions now, but they are still waiting on forensics tests to lead them to the truth. The site of what is now called the biggest crime in Pickens County in three decades is slowly turning into a memorial.
God, please rest them in peace.
Michelle Lawrence came out of respect for the youngest victim, 20-year-old Marshall Hendricks. They work together at YH America.
There's something missing from this puzzle, and they need to find it to help these boys and their dad and grandmother.
Marshall, his brother Matthew, their father Mark, and their grandmother Linda Burns were found shot to death Friday on the family's property in Pinedale Road. This family home that asks for a blessing has seen its share of tragedy, and the past is creeping into this investigation. Authorities say in April of 2006, Susan Hendricks killed an intruder in self-defense. She is the only member of the Hendricks family who lives on Pinedale Road who wasn't killed on Friday. And while she found the bodies, Authorities say she did not call 911. Another family member called it in. And investigators say the public needs to remember there are no quick answers in a case this complicated with so much history.
We want to get answers for the family, for the public, and for us. And it's just going to take time.
Now, investigators tell us they did recover a gun on Friday, and they say it is not the same caliber as the gun that was used in that 2006 shooting. Michael.
Angela, thank you. Another county is looking to ban so-called bath salts. Now, here we're not talking about bath salts you might use in your tub. These are chemicals that'll get someone high, create hallucinations. People snort, inject, or smoke this stuff, and right now it is illegal to buy this sort of bath salts. Many counties are banning this. In one meeting tonight, we're going on right now, Spartanburg County Council proposes to ban the advertisement, purchase, or distribution of bath salts. This is the first reading of that proposal.
Kemet has a new plant in Simpsonville. The company had a ribbon cutting today for the new Simpsonville Power Film Manufacturing Plant. It's located on Kemet Way. The plant is a $32 million investment, and that comes with more than 110 new jobs. The facility will make capacitors for electric vehicle applications.
Well, the Gamecocks are off to one of their best starts in recent years, but tonight the team and the fans are having to deal with the injury of star running back Marcus Lattimore. News 4's Mike Giordano is here to break it all down for us. Mike, this is significant.
Yeah, absolutely, Michael. Marcus Lattimore is that rare player, a guy with exceptional talent who's also one of the team's hardest workers and has a spirit that inspires his teammates. USC lost all of that with the news Lattimore's season is over after injuring a ligament in his left knee on Saturday. Lattimore injured the knee in the win over Mississippi State. He was blocking for a teammate when a Mississippi State defender rolled up on his leg. The former Burns star was treated on the sidelines with a large padded brace and left the field on crutches. Lattimore will undergo knee surgery in the coming weeks. Spurrier says Lattimore is doing okay, the head ball coach telling his sophomore running back, "Time heals a lot of wounds. Just give it time and get yourself ready to come back stronger next season." This season, Lattimore, second leading rusher in the SEC, more than 800 yards and 10 touchdowns. He also scored a touchdown as a receiver. Lattimore himself making up 36% of the Gamecocks' total offense. Now, combine that with quarterback Steven Garcia, who was dismissed from the team, and the Gamecocks have lost 72% of their offense in the past week. Freshman Brandon Wilds will likely replace Lattimore in the starting lineup when the Gamecocks travel to Tennessee on October 29th. But game time for that ballgame coming up later on in sports.
We feel that this is a pretty dark time for Spartanburg County and the animals in it.
Stray dogs and cats are at the center of a battle over bills in Spartanburg County, why the animals could be spending the night in a truck.
And later on News 4, protecting your children from an accidental drug overdose. Tonight, why a new study shows many parents are to blame.
And current pollen count outside right now. Trees and grasses are in the low category, but weeds, mainly ragweed and mold, in the moderate category. I'll be back a little bit later on.
Stray animals are paying the price for a bill battle in Spartanburg County. The Spartanburg Humane Society says Spartanburg County has not paid its balance of $200,000. That's for the housing and care of stray animals dropped off by animal control. The Humane Society says county leaders have ignored calls and emails. So effective this evening, the Humane Society won't accept strays dropped off by animal control unless they're hurt or sick. The county council chairman calls it a misunderstanding and believes the bill that's owed will be paid.
We were really looking forward to having a check in the mail and not having to go through all this, but they've kind of left us with no other options.
According to county staff, they just had not received a bill, and then when they did get a bill, it contained a lot of charges that were unexplained.
Animal Control says strays picked up tonight will be kept in the agency's trucks, which is allowed for 24 hours as long as they're given food, water, and bathroom breaks.
A bear and three cubs have taken up residence in a neighborhood tree in Asheville. Check out the pictures. These come to us from the police department. The officers received the call just after noon today of a bear sighting on Virginia Avenue. This is West Asheville. Now, when police got there, they saw one large adult bear and the three cubs in that tree. And the police tell us the bears do not appear aggressive, but also show no inclination to move along either. People in this area have been notified, and we're told the North Carolina Wildlife Commission will patrol the area until the bears decide to leave.
Kids are curious. They really want to try and get into whatever they can get their hands on.
Next on News 4, the medicine mistakes that many parents are making.
Outside the Greenville area right now, plenty of sunshine, a warm breeze out of the southwest, but some big changes on the way. We'll talk about that next.
From Studio One at Broadcast Place, live local breaking news continues.
Most accidental drug overdoses involving children happen at home. According to new research, many parents are not making their medicine cabinets as childproof as they should be, especially when some medications look an awful lot like candy. Erica Edwards reports.
Where there's candy, there are kids. But sometimes even the family medicine cabinet can look like a candy store to young children. It's hard to tell which of these tablets are sweet tarts and which are Tums antacids. And cold medicine chloracetin looks an awful lot like red M&Ms. But in a new study, more than 1 in 4 kindergartners couldn't tell the difference between candy and over-the-counter medications. Because of this common confusion, experts say it's crucial all medicines are locked up or put high enough that they're out of reach.
Kids are curious. They really want to try and get into whatever they can get their hands on.
Lindsay Oste of Nationwide Children's Hospital in Columbus, Ohio, conducted another new study looking at how medications are stored inside the home. When researchers looked through 24 households, nearly a third of homes had drugs containing the pain reliever acetaminophen within reach of kids under age 6.
Oh, here's December 05.
Oste says this should alert parents to check their homes for medicine that should be locked away or thrown away.
Every home that we went into had at least one expired medication.
Making sure medicines are up to date and up out of the way can help parents make sure their homes and kids are as safe as possible. Erica Edwards, NBC News.
It is about to get a little cooler.
Yeah.
Cooler, colder.
Yeah.
In fact, Carol Michael, I wouldn't be surprised, maybe late Wednesday night, or even during the probably Wednesday night, maybe even some snow showers along the Tennessee North Carolina border.
Come on.
Yeah. Listen to Michael. Come on. Hey, you know, we're heading in the middle of October now. This is very typical. Extremely cold air is on the way for us. Tomorrow's going to be fairly mild as we have a cold front coming in from the west and a storm system coming out of the south. At least that's going to bring us some pretty good soaking rains tomorrow night. Now, we could see a few showers as early as tomorrow afternoon, but most likely tomorrow night will be the main event as far as precipitation goes. All right, live Super Doppler 4HD, nice and quiet, and it is going to stay dry tonight through tomorrow morning. And then the changes will be on the way. Outside, plenty of sunshine in the Greenville area. Right now, warm 81 degrees, southwest breeze at 13 miles per hour, humidity not extremely high at 35%. In Spartanburg, sunshine, currently 79 degrees, southwest wind at 14 miles per hour, humidity right now at 39%. And in Anderson, plenty of sunshine, currently 81 degree temperature, nice and warm, southwest wind at 8 miles per hour, humidity at 38%, barometric pressure 29.88. Plenty of sunshine, a few high thin cirrus clouds in Asheville, right now 77 degrees, southwest wind at 13 miles per hour, humidity right now at 40%. Here's what it looks like in the southeast. We have a stationary front to our north, and that's where some clouds are, even a few showers back in through Missouri, moving through around St. Louis. Stationary, meaning it's not going anywhere. In fact, it most likely will turn into a warm front and lift northward during the day tomorrow. So this will bring us some clouds, as you can see, in the northern mountains of North Carolina, but that's about it. A couple of clouds in the mountains of North Carolina, but for the most part, it's going to be dry, and the farther south you go, more clear weather. And then we'll see some clouds creeping up from the south as we go through the day tomorrow. Look how warm it is in the south. 84 right now in Macon, 82 in Atlanta, 83 in Augusta, also in Florence, 81 right now in Hilton Head. It's currently 80 in Raleigh. A little bit cooler, but not bad along the beaches, 75 degrees in Myrtle Beach. Southerly wind, a little bit of a sea breeze, keeping temperatures down a little bit there. 78 right now in Charleston, upper 70s also in Wilmington. 82 currently in Greenwood, while it's 72 degrees right now in Boone. All right, here's what it looks like. High temperatures so far today. Normally, we should be in the low 70s in the upstate this time of the year, October 17th, and usually upper 60s in the mountains, so obviously way above the average for this time of the year. Got pretty close to the records, by the way. These are the temperature highs so far. I'll update these for you at 11 o'clock tonight because we could still warm up another degree or two before sunset, which is at 6:52 this evening, getting earlier and earlier on that sunset. We lose about 2 minutes a day as far as daylight. 81 the high so far at the Asheville Airport. The record in the mountains, 85 degrees, set way back in 1897. 86 the record high in the upstate, set back in 1916. We got pretty close to that, especially a few folks in Greenwood. 85 so far the high in Greenwood. So some showers and thunder showers to our northwest. Storm system getting organized in the southeastern Gulf of Mexico is going to move northward. All the rain in southern Florida, some of that rain has been extremely heavy. So clear skies, sunshine tomorrow morning. Here comes a cold front in from the west. And then here comes the storm system out of the eastern Gulf of Mexico, kind of a sandwich, and the best chance of rain will be in the southern part of the upstate back into Elbert County. And then all this will lift across the entire viewing area as we go through tomorrow night. Fairly mild tomorrow with the increasing clouds in the afternoon. So 46 for the overnight low tonight in the mountains, 57 in the upstate with mainly clear skies tomorrow. Increasing clouds in the afternoon, some showers around, maybe even a thunderstorm, especially south of I-85, the farther north you go. Only isolated showers in the mountains tomorrow afternoon. And then showers and possible thunderstorms will continue to spread across the area tomorrow night, a good chance of rain across the area. And then ending by Wednesday afternoon in the upstate, but continuing off and on in the mountains during the day on Wednesday. The winds will be quite strong on Wednesday and much cooler weather, as you can see. And then colder, drier air really comes in as we get into the end of this week and into the upcoming weekend. Good football weather, nice and crisp, but it will be